Ready to fight? Ready. Let's do it.
All right, so here's the former UFC light heavyweight champion, John Jones, immediately taking the center of the octagon. You know, he's got a lot of weapons. We'll see how he approaches this fight early as he tries to get a 10th career win by knockout. Investing in the body with the kick there. All right, no surprise to see Johnny Bones Jones open with some of those long-range weapons and finding some early success in this one.
That's exactly what he does. He throws the front kick to the leg, and he throws those lead kicks to the body. He's long, 6'4 for the weight class, and he has learned masterfully how to fight with his height and his range. All those long-range weapons are John Jones' calling card.
Oh, roundhouse kick. At this point, DC, I'm not sure if he's just biding his time or just trying to get some extra reps, but go finish the guy.
Seems like the guy's playing with his crew. You know, he's having to.
Crowd continues to sway with every huge shot being landed. Back and forth we go. Nice jab. Dell's head kick attempt, that one is blocked. All right, so he's dealing with some swelling upstairs, and you gotta think his opponent is gonna continue to attack that region.
Well, he has to. He's starting to see now the work is being done. He's starting to see the benefits of the work with the swelling that's starting to occur.
Under 3 minutes now to go on the round. Back and forth we go. Nice defense to block the elbow. Jones is now dealing with a cheek cut.
Hit him with the low kick.
Oh, nice land there with the punch. You see, he's taking advantage of what is an obvious edge and reach. Pinpoint jab from Johnny Bones. 84-inch reach. Must be nice, DC, right, to have that length? Ooh. So as we pull up some numbers here for you, 29 total strikes have landed for John Jones. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Whips on the elbow.
Another big one.
Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Ooh, you didn't see that one coming. Beautiful combination up top. What a great sequence by him, mixing up his strikes and once again targeting that already damaged, swollen area upstairs.
That's exactly what he should do. You know, we are talking about a guy that is so talented, that is so disciplined, that when he can see swelling like that, he's going to continue to attack it.
Can survive.
I cannot believe he is still standing after taking that punch.
Oh, nice takedown. Yep.
Jones has got him in a crucifix now. Gonna go to work from the top. Oh, and a cut just opened up on his forehead. Jones is trying for a submission here. Oh, he's got the Kimura position locked in now. Gonna continue.
Oh my goodness, I thought it was over. I thought this fight was over.
Well, John Jones showing you some of those new weapons here tonight. Mike Winklejohn is always fond of saying you don't see 30% of what Johnny Bones is able to do in the gym. And with every passing fight, straight connections right up the gut, DC. He's in a world of trouble now.
They say the straight moves are the ones that get there first, and it got right to the target.
Leather being thrown on both sides. Jones's cut on his forehead is so bad at this point that maybe. Oh, big diving punch lands up top. straight ahead. All right, heading back to the corner, and Jones's face is just masked in blood. I'm not sure if there's anything the cut man or woman can do in this situation. Probably not going to be able to stave off the doctor. This could very well be the end of the fight. All right, DC, we got a few clips of the damage done in that round. Can see where things really started to escalate.
Yeah, really open up that cut, John. The blows are just devastating. He's got to get out of the way more. I mean, if this guy won't do it himself, somebody's got to help him.
Yeah.
Because you cannot keep taking these types of shots.
You ready? You ready?
Good. Round two underway. Do you believe it? This next round is underway. In the previous round, both fighters got rocked. Crowd going bananas. Big opportunity for both fighters.
These are the types of fights that makes it so fun to sit right next to the octagon and call the action.
Jones is an absolute mess right now. This fight might actually get stopped by the ringside physician due to that cut. Big shots here. Pretty accurate there from bottom position. Oh, interesting there as he just decides to let him back up. All right, well, good news is he...
Oh, my goodness.
All right, so when is too much too much? I mean, I'm not sure I need to see the spider absorb any further damage here.
It's okay if his corner or the ringside position calls a stop to this man. He has been battered, he has been beaten, and the result is not going to change. Trading huge shots. Let's see who's going to be the last man standing.
All right, so the referee right then and there has called a stop to the action. Looks like he's going to call on the doctor to look at the cut, and it is a pretty significant one, DC.
Well, he's bleeding a lot. And the blood is going into his eyes. It's very difficult for him to see right now.
Yeah, that's it. That thing's bleeding like a faucet. Fans don't like it. Fighter doesn't like it. But he will live to fight another day. Here's Bruce Buffer now with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, the doctor has called a stop to this fight, declaring the winner by TKO and still the undisputed UFC light heavyweight champion of the world, Chuck the Iceman Liddell.
All right, so a nice retention of the title tonight. Our UFC light heavyweight champion gets it done in a big way here.
We hear it over and over again in regards to this guy. He is very good. He is a very big, strong 205-pound fighter and a guy that is going to take a massive effort to try to take the belt away from him.